Thank you. Hello. I can barely see you because it is so dark out, but thank you for being here. And I would like to introduce to you Cassie Olson here in cello and Bonnie Terry in violin. And my name is Vedrina Subotic. I am the music director of local concert series, intermezzo concerts, and we frequently collaborate with our friends at Excellence in the community to come together like this and perform classical music programs for you. So we're happy to be here tonight, this beautiful evening in Salt Lake City. We will have just a brief pause where I would like to invite Jeff Whiteley to come on stage and say a few words about all our wonderful sponsors who are making these concerts free and open to the public. And then Bonnie and I will come back and perform a sonata for violin and piano by Beethoven.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. What do you think of these fabulous Utah musicians? What I love about quality music is in a time, in an era of so much discord and strife, they demonstrate that harmony is possible, that people can come together to create beauty instead of division. So, welcome to the Excellence in the Community Concert Series. This is a collaboration tonight with the Intermezzo Concerts and always with the Gallivan Center. And as you probably know, we put on concerts regularly featuring always Utah musicians and a wide variety of musical styles. Now, I say this all the time, but it illustrates the point. What did you think of the ticket price? We work hard to make these concerts available to everybody, all ages, all demographics, because we want quality music to enhance and enliven and make a statement in downtown Salt Lake City. Now, who makes it possible? Talitha Day and the Gallivan Center, the Salt Lake City Redevelopment Agency, the Salt Lake City Mayor, Aaron Mendenhall, the Salt Lake City Council, Zoo Arts and Parks, Taylor Audio Visual. How is the quality of the sound? It sounded pretty good to me out there. The Utah Division of Arts and Museums, Larry Miller Family Charities, the George S. and Dolores Dore Eccles Foundation, Merit Medical, AARP, the R. Harold Burton Foundation, Excellence in the Community, and of course the Excellence in the Community crew and the Taylor Audio crew. Oh, I almost forgot. You're probably close enough to see the logo on the side of the piano. If not, it says Steinway & Sons. This is a 7-foot Steinway grand piano. It was tuned today, and it was brought here for you because Skip Daines and Daines Music want Vedrina to play an instrument commensurate with her talent. How about a round of applause for these great sponsors? If you're interested in joining us again, we have concerts every Wednesday night. We're just closing out our summer season. The concerts will be outdoors until weather obliges us to go indoors. The concerts are always no charge. They feature a wide variety of Utah musicians. You can find our schedule at excellenceconcerts.org. And we have here QR codes that take you to our website if you're interested in making a donation or if you're interested just in learning more about us. We're a nonprofit. We started almost 17 years ago, and we have produced about 1,100 concerts throughout the state. Now, of particular interest tonight, you see the roving cameraman. You see the cameras. When COVID came to town in March of 2020, it shut down our public concerts. So we moved to doing live stream only. and we were able to actually double our programming at the Gallivan Center because there was such a great need both for the musicians and for the community for some sort of healing, and for the musicians, some sort of work. So since then, we've tried to live stream as many concerts as we can. So we've live streamed now about 200 of these. The interesting thing is the popularity these live streams from the Gallivan Center have achieved around the world. So we just crossed the 32 million view mark, and the 32 million viewers have spent about 26 years watching Utah musicians. This concert tonight will be live streamed, and thus far in 2020, the average per concert is about 275,000 views. So we think that's good news for Utah. That's what we're working on. I'm probably forgetting something, but I'm going to make sure the artists are ready. So just a moment here. Are you ready, or should I tell some more stories? Okay. Please welcome Bonnie Terry and Vedrina Subacik. And these are our friends, these are your neighbors, these are Utah musicians. We are honored at the expertise they bring to the stage. And I love the concept in music that to play like this, you have to put effort into it. So this is achievement. This is hours and hours and hours of work. And it's here today, tonight, to make our city more interesting and a more interesting place. But I am so glad you're here to share in what they have achieved. Thank you very much for coming.
Thank you. Thank you.
I didn't realize you didn't have printed programs. How silly of me. So I didn't tell you what we were playing. So back, rewind. Remember every note that we played. So the first piece for the violoncello and piano was by Anton Arensky, a Russian composer who lived in the later half of the 19th century, and composed a number of really delightful pieces, lots of chamber music, suites for two pianos, very sort of imperial salon style, intended, of course, to be performed for a crowd of Russian nobility in situations such as evenings and receptions at Tsar's palace. So he was lesser known than his pupils, who became quite famous, like Rachmaninoff. He himself was very influenced by Tchaikovsky, and you probably recall there were quite a number of Russian-sounding folk themes, but essentially it is sort of a high salon style, is how I would describe it. It was dedicated to a well-known Russian cellist, whose name escapes me right now, but this same cellist to whom the trio was dedicated was also dedicatee of some of the works by Robert Schumann, who traveled to Russia at some point with his wife Clara earlier. He was older than Arensky. So there's a connection there. And the second work on the program was by Beethoven, known as Spring Sonata, and though it is not spring anymore, sadly, it is a beautiful fall, and we thought it would be a lovely piece to perform for you here in this outdoor setting. It was presented to you as written in four movements, as you probably recall, and Beethoven's works in the key of F major, in which he composed this particular piece, are typically pastoral and lyrical in spirit and affect, and they tend to depict nature and it's all its beauty and glory. One of the pieces that comes to mind that is also famously in F major is his so-called Pastoral Symphony, number 6. So if you're familiar with that piece, I'm sure that you would be hearing lots of similarities between what Bonnie and I performed tonight and that particular symphony. I hope you enjoyed the evening and that you will continue to join us for these presentations of classical music. Classical music is great and, of course, dear and near to my heart. I love it, and I hope that by performing these works for you tonight, we have enticed you to come back and hear some more. So thank you very much again for being here tonight.
Vedrina reminds me, she'll be back with Intermezzo the last Wednesday of October.
That's right.
And we'll be here, again, a collaboration with Gallivan Center, Excellence in the Community, and the Intermezzo Concert Series. And I also forgot, thanks so much for coming. And we do have a tradition. We're a volunteer organization. You can help us by folding up your chairs and putting them in stacks of 5 on this dance floor. Thank you so much. ExcellenceConcerts.org. Come back again.